In the 20th century, electronics such as computers
and music players
changed everything. The 21st century promises a new revolution.
Photonics.
This is the Qubit Lab.
Computers based on particles of light instead of electronic signals could be millions of times more powerful than today's best number crunchers, taking the most difficult computations and making them easier.
Things like predicting the weather, the structure of drugs and medicine, even cracking encryption codes.
So how do you make a computer with light? In modern electronics, complex processors are written onto tiny microchips. These are called integrated circuits.
Researchers from Italy and Bristol and Oxford in the UK are developing tiny on-chip processors for light. This is the dawn of integrated optics.
Light is made from quantum particles called photons. Photons carry information, and when photons interact, this information is processed, allowing computations.
But photons also behave like waves, spreading out like ripples on a pond. It's easy to lose them. So the secret to integrated optics is waveguides.
We've all seen these. Simple optical fibers. These are a type of waveguide. Because light enters through one end, it's trapped and travels along the fiber without escaping. The internet is based on fibers like this.
But you can't create a computer with just wires. You need processors where information is crunched. This chip has tiny waveguides written into it, which cross over so that photons interact in controllable ways.
The waveguides are written by blasting a glass chip with ultra-short, intense laser pulses. By adjusting the depth of focus of the laser while the chips are moved around, guides can be written in 3D, winding around each other to produce any degree of interaction. Already, integrated circuits have been used to demonstrate quantum properties of photons as they hop between different waveguides on a chip.
And circuits like these can be used to create tiny optical sensors capable of detecting small concentrations of chemicals in contact with the chip.
And that's not all. Researchers are hoping to include tiny light sources and tiny photon detectors on the same chip. This would mean that photons would be manufactured, processed, and measured all in the same minuscule device.
Laptops powered by light may be some years away still, but integrated photonics could form the basis for a range of new technologies benefiting from the quantum properties of light.
I'm Gabe.
And I'm Laura.
And this has been enlightening.
Oh, see you next time.
Enlightening, come on. You light up my life. You're my light and shining armor. Can I bum a light? You're being impolite.
Ooh, that's a good one.